Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can count even and odd numbers present in array by passing array into function using pointer. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechImage, which is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement solution of this problem. So first I am including a header file, that is stdio.h. Now I am declaring a function whose name is count. Its return type is void and it will receive an argument, that is address of base location of array. So this statement is function declaration. Now I am going to define main function. Inside main, I am declaring two variables. First one is array and second one is integer variable I. Now with the help of printf, the message enter 10 elements will be displayed on console. To read the element from user, I am applying this for loop, which will repeat 10 times and it will read 10 elements from user, and all the elements will be stored inside array A. Now I am calling count function. In this I am passing array A. So count is called here and I am passing A array into it. So its base address will be passed in function definition and then return 0. This is the implementation of main function. Now I have to define definition of count function. So for that purpose I have implemented this block. This block will be known as function definition. Inside this function, I am declaring some variables. So total three variables are declared, I, C1 and C2. C1, C2 are initialized with 0. Now I am going to implement for loop. This for loop will repeat 10 times. Inside this for loop, I have to apply the condition, which will check whether the element is even or odd. So this is the condition. Here asterisk P is divided by 2. If its remainder is 0, then number is even, otherwise it is odd. So P is containing base address of the array. To receive element which is available on base location, I have used asterisk P. So if this condition is true, then C1 will be incremented by 1. If this condition is false, then C2 will be incremented by 1. Now after this if else condition, P will be incremented. So P++ will be shifting pointer through first location to second location of array. So whenever we want to jump to different locations of array, we have to increase the address which is stored inside pointer through P++ or that variable and ++ operator. So this way 10 times this loop will repeat, 10 times condition will be checked and P will be incremented to provide the locations of array through its address. After completion of this loop, I can print the counted values on console with the help of printf. So even equals to %d and odd equals to %d, comma C1, comma C2. So with this printf, the results of counted values will be displayed on console through C1 and C2. So this way I have implemented the complete code in front of you. Now I am going to execute this code. So it is asking for elements. So I am entering 10 elements. You can see the output. Even numbers are 5 and odd numbers are 5. So the input contains 5 even and 5 odd elements. So output is printed correctly. So this way I have implemented this program by passing array into function using pointer to count how many even and odd numbers are available in array. I hope you have understood the logic. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechImage, which is available on Google Play. Thank you for watching this video.